guest organist. I have to get him straight. Make sure he plays in all the keys, because you know how some of them transpose the keys. But he's a wonderful friend. I've been knowing Sean for over 30-something years.
I'm gonna get you like this. I'm gonna get you like this. Praise the Lord, everybody. Children who are here on this morning. Amen. One of them is tending to the baby right now, but as soon as she's done, I'm going to ask her to come and give some words. Amen. Sister Nicole Bush. Amen.
God's presence is all over. I just want to thank God for her, having her in my life. I came to her when I was 5 years old, and she's the only mother I've ever known. She's taken care of me through thick and thin, fights, fist fights, arguments, everything. You know, she's just been there. She's a provider. She takes care of everybody who comes into her presence. And I just want to say happy birthday, Mom.
That was beautiful. That was beautiful. We thank God. We're going to keep it moving right now. Come on up here, Brother DeAndre, and say some words for Mom. Come on up. Amen.
First of all, happy birthday. I just really want to say thank you. You know, always been there. I haven't been the best child, and I've been through a lot. And you always,
praise God.
I felt he was like the hope.
Yes.
And I just want to thank you for that.
Yes.
And I just don't understand. I don't know how you did it with all of us, because we all had you pulling by the string each way. But you did, and I just want to thank you for that.
Thank you so much for those words.
Nice.
Truly, in this day and time that we're living in, you can't take life for granted, because tomorrow's not promised. I remember a few years back, my wife had given me a surprise 40th birthday party, and some people questioned, well, why would you do it at 40? you know, 50 is the year that, you know, most people, some people felt that you should do it at, but my wife felt that she wanted to do it at 40 because of some health challenges that I was going through at that time. And I said that to say, this past week we went to New York to bury a dear friend and brother of ours who was 49, and his friend was planning a 50th party for him, and he didn't make it. He died 2 days before his 50th birthday. So I said that to say, you just never, don't take life for granted. Your loved ones, if you want to do something for them, do it. No matter if it's 20, 21, 30, 32, 35, because like I said, tomorrow's not promised. And life is precious, and we just need to appreciate and appreciate those who are in our lives. Amen. So with that being said, well, I'm not really, I don't think I'm putting this brother on the spot, because I did give word to him that I was going to ask him to give us a song on this morning. So without any further ado, all the way from New York.
No, it's not me.
We're going to have our deacon, Layman Pullins, coming up here and bless us with a song. Yeah. I call him the gospel sounds, Sam Cooke.
Precious Lord, take my hand, lead me on, let me stand. I am tired, I am weak, I am worn. Through the storm,
thank you. going further in the program, we're going to call on a very dear friend to our Reverend Bush. He's a man that came into our life a few years ago, and he has been such a tremendous blessing in so many ways. He has shown that term friendship and brotherhood. He put it to action. Okay, it wasn't just saying it, but he actually put it to action. In fact, he put it to action so much so that those cheers that you're sitting on actually came from his church. Amen. And he didn't look for anything and ask for anything in return. And he didn't also call him either. But without any further ado, I'm going to ask our Bishop Nathan Ford to come up and give some words. Amen.
Amen. God bless you all. Come on, give God a hand clap. For such a fine occasion as this, and such a fine woman of God as this, amen. I'm sure y'all can agree. Let's give her a hand clap of praise and hope. And we come to celebrate this fine woman of God. I'm sure she can be better than that, amen. Come on, let's go on and celebrate. Come on, give her a just beat. Give her a flower while she gets here. But I wouldn't have missed it for anything. And I hope you are surprised. Amen. And all of you in your respective places, please forgive me, but I'm not here to take up any time. I just want to get up and say, I'm glad to be here. I love you. And if there's anything going on, if you are involved, then you know I'm going to try my best to be there. I love you all, open arms, thank you. And we're glad to be here. My wife, she's at another assignment, but she does send her love in her absence. Amen. We thank you all. God bless you.
Amen. We thank you so much for those words. Amen. We're going to keep it rolling right on along. Amen. We're going to call on our very own Minister Gary Cole to come up and give us some words on this. Some brief words, my brother. Some brief words.
Praise God, praise God. I'm just so glad to be here, my wife. Amen. I want to have my wife say a little something too also. So honey, if you give the baby to somebody and you come on up, I would appreciate it. And I just want to thank God for Reverend Gail Bush. Amen. Amen. Praise God. We came to know her in such a special way, we can call her friend. And it's hard these days when you can say you can call someone your friend. And it's more like we're family also. We're so connected, it's ridiculous. And we just thank God that we are here. We're honored, just very honored, just to be in the number. I'm just being honest with you. This is a great, great woman of God. She will go out of her way. She will go above and beyond any call that she would have. She will go for anybody, for anyone. And that's the reason why it's called Open Arms, is because her arms are always open, no matter what. And like I said, I know the children and I know their testimonies, and like they said, she is that type of person that will go out of her way and do and give and give and give and give and give. And so we just thank God that we're in her presence. We got to know her, we're getting to know her, that we are just with her and what she's trying to do. We just thank God for her life and for her living.
Amen.
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 Yeah. Usually if they call me to say something about somebody and I'm not prepared, I get very nervous. But with Reverend Gail, that's the way I call her, I'm not very nervous because she's truly, some of us, we wake up in the morning, I know I do. I say, Lord, let my light shine so others can see Christ in me. I mean, this woman let her light shine every day. I've never heard Reverend Gail say any negative things. I don't think there's no in her vocabulary because she's always say yes. when you're discouraged, you say, I can't do this. Oh no, you can, let me tell you what you can do. She's always there to help. And I'm gonna also call her a chameleon in a good way, because even when she's with young people, she act like them. My daughters tell me, Mommy, I usually don't like your friends, but I love Reverend Gail. So that's to show you what kind of a person she is. And I'm just a blessing to me and my family.
Amen. Amen. Let's give our speaker, Pastor Phillips, a hand. Amen. We're going to keep it rolling right along. I'm going to put someone else on the spot, but I have to do it. Amen. That's none other than one of our family members, amen, who just relocated here from New York.
All right.
Amen. Come on up. I'm Betty. Don't look at me. Woo! Amen. It seems like the whole family is migrating to Georgia. I don't know what it is. Amen.
Praise the Lord, everybody. I'm just happy to be here today and give honor to God for allowing me to a chance just to come to say happy birthday to my cousin Gail.
Amen.
You know, I've heard it said many times, if you want to know what a person living, watch the family. And I'm here today standing prayer to say that ever since I've known, I have to say, Gail, y'all excuse me. I babysitted her. Little girl. You know, but she has always been a true Christian. And she's always been everything everybody said about her, it's all true. She's always reached out to help somebody.
Yeah,
and
yeah.
Many times she's reached out and helped me, you know, just in kind words and all. And I'm just so glad that I can come here and say happy birthday to her. And I wish you many, many more birthdays.
Amen.
And Fitty is going to pay for this.
Amen. We're going to keep it rolling right on the wall. Amen. Without any further ado, we have a special treat for y'all on this morning. We have our Reverend Bush's grandson who is going to render her a song in his own way. Amen. 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 Let's put your hands together for Brother Dion.
This song right here is called This Is How We Praise It. So we're going to do this real quick for y'all. So if everybody want to get up on your feet right now, we're going to do this old school. We're going to take it back, y'all. We're going to take it back, y'all. Come on. Get up. Get where we are. Come on. Put your hands in the air. Come on. This is how we raise them. Now this is how we pray them every Sunday. Now this is how we praise them. Now we raise them every Sunday. Yep, and we got up in the church and we're all ready. Yep, I got my friends in me. Yep, look them in great. I'm a friend of really got because they're going up the church. Yeah, I'm talking about the D.O.D. I'm talking about my men. I have four in the truck. I see my friends and I see the food. Now we wrap up on the truck. We're ready up. I better give it a rock. Then I pray to God. Yep, and I'm feeling all right. If you know what I mean, I got to feel good. And if you know what I mean,
everybody.
check it out. Yeah, the old city, we go on looking for me. I'm talking about, man, I fill up with gas, man, I fill up with gas, attack, man, I'm talking about Jesus Christ. You're the one that died. Let me tell you about the type of one. Yeah, if you're down with me, oh, bitch, you better be down. And if you ain't down with Christ, then what you doing, boy? You still a dope man. I'm talking about God. Come on. This is how we praise Him.
She just came there, her and her husband just got comfortable and she began to play for us, and she's our organist. What a blessing. Amen. I'm just truly blessed. I just to be a part, to know this family. Anybody being a part of this family, know that they are anointed, they're truly talented, and I just thank God they have a testimony all in this one family. I thought I heard it all, but they got a continuous testimony that draws you closer to them. That God is able to do all things exceedingly abundantly above all that we can see, tell, or ask. So I just thank God for Sister Gail and his whole family. And just think I'm not going to prolong the program because I'm just glad to be able to say something for this young lady, amen. This God lady, this God sent lady, happy birthday to you, and many, many more. God bless you.
Amen. You know, we're going to keep it moving right on along. We're going to call another dear friend to the family who's a preaching man and a wonderful man of God, wonderful anointed musician as well. In fact, if you're not busy tomorrow afternoon, he'll be preaching for her. She didn't know this, but he'll be preaching for her on tomorrow, part two of her birthday celebration. So put your hands together for our Bishop Brian Bacon.
Well, praise the Lord, everybody.
Praise the Lord.
We come today sending greetings from Promised Land Christian Church to my friend, my sister, and I also call her mom. Want to thank you so much for how you've impacted my life. You may not even know all of this, but Every time we come in contact with you, you say something that I need to hear. And I really appreciate it. I appreciate your stance on holiness and righteousness. I had the privilege to sit at dinner with you not long ago. And a lot of times being young preachers, we go through things that we don't talk about. And I was trying to make some decisions on some things. And you said something at the table that stuck with me, and I will never forget it. You said, don't ever let your good be evil spoken of. And it blessed me in ways you have no idea. And so today I come to just to say thank you and celebrate you on your great day. Happy birthday to you. And when I look at this Bush family, everybody that knows the Bushes know that they are some people to love.
Amen.
They're the most humble, most sincere people that I've ever known. I thank God for being a part of this family. I'm not just a friend, I'm family. I adopted myself into the family. But listening to all the testimonies, every time the Lord brings us all in contact with each other, and on the way here, the Lord showed me that bush that Moses saw. And the reality was, that bush was going through something. Truth is, it was on fire. That bush was burning. And today the Lord showed me that it's also a picture of this Bush family. Because no matter what it has gone through, it wasn't consumed. All because the hand of God was on that bush. So no matter what came to the bush, God's hand was stronger than whatever the attack was. And that's what I see when I see this Bush family still standing, still preaching, still smiling, still helping. And I just want to tell you on today, Pastor Bush, that we love you.
Amen.
And we praise God for how you've mothered all of us. And you have no idea how we're leaning on you. But we thank you today and we celebrate you. Enjoy your day. And would y'all help me bless God for our mother's day?
Amen. Now, just a preview of what he's going to do on tomorrow. I tell you, he's young. When I first met him, I told him he's young. But he's like an old man when he gets behind the
pulpit. How she would always, you know, you had to go to church if you lived at 27 Washington Place. There was nothing about it. You went to church. But I thought about, and I thank God for that because that saved my life. But I thought about my children, how great of a grandmother she is. And she's a typical grandmother, like forgets all the rules. But when my kids were younger, If I reprimanded them, especially this one right here, he would get beside himself, I'm going to go tell grandma about you. And I thought about that. I was like, they'll be 20, and I know that they still do that. When we don't agree, somehow or another, they end up in grandma's car with a soda or going to get something to eat, and I know that they're telling on me. So, but it sounds funny, and it is what it is, but it just speaks about the relationship that they had, that they know that they can trust her. And we don't agree on a lot of things. I see things one way and the other way, but we disagree in love. And I know that, you know, what her putting into them and what I'm putting into them, even though it may not be the same thing, is helping to shape them and mold them in the men that they are. Because I'm a single mother and I can't do it alone. But I've told people many years, I said, oh yeah, my children have a father. They had this wonderful stepfather. I said, but my baby daddy is my mother. And I said, and she has been there since day one, even though when I was in labor, she was taking in foster children that night. But, you know, daughter's in labor, but, you know, she's just a wonderful woman. So,
without any further ado, I'm going to call on a dear friend of family of my mother. They go way, 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 way back. Ever since I remember him being a part of our life. Amen. And another person who's from New York as well, somehow relocated down here to Georgia. Amen. And that's not another door, our brother Hilton Armstrong.
Faithful.
got some kids. That commercial that's on television, you know, like a little Volkswagen, you keep having kids come out. How many kids she got in there? She always had personal ways, you know, bringing the kids, doing the things of God. And I appreciate that, man. You have lived a life that I have admired. And I always appreciate you. Thank you very much, and happy, happy birthday. Amen.
Further ado, I'm going to call on the man that helped, I guess, conceive me. Amen. It takes two to make a thing go right. They certainly did something right when they made me that. Amen. So come on up, Pop.
It's 44 years. Woo! She was 45. I'm saying that she had to be a woman of God to stay with me on 44 years. But she stuck in there with me. I just want to thank you for something for that. You know, this is my first time. I've been out to church there for about 5 weeks. When I went to New York, came back, I got real sick. And I've been in there ever since. So I pressed my way out Thursday to take a little breakfast for my birthday. And I pressed my way out today to be in this church.
Amen.
I want to thank the both of this.
Amen.
Amen.
And also, God, I want to give you this. I know when you get into your car, get to that gate, you couldn't open the gate. Out of the car, this is the remote control for that gate.
Amen. But before we do, amen. I'm sorry. Come on up. This is another dear friend to the family. Amen. A wonderful, him and his wife, both beautiful people. Amen. Well, we met them at Christ the King originally. And then, beautiful, like I said, beautiful couple. His wife is a beautiful woman of God. Appreciate all that night. Amen. He's a beautiful man of God. And he says he's a great bowler, Brother Hill. He says he's a great boy. Amen. So I don't know who's gonna speak, but come on up, Buck Bunger. Just come on up. Yeah. I can't get that last name. I know them all these years. I still can't get that last name right.
Good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
I've been knowing him for a long time. We joke, have fun.
Amen.
And one day she came in the church, I said I was gonna fire her, but I think I'm gonna keep her for a little while. But really, she has been a dear friend, and we got along, so it's been a long time. We've been on this for a while. And I thank God for you, and you have many happy birthdays.
Amen. Amen. Truly, it's an honor to be here with Mother Bush. One thing I can say about her, she has a very humble spirit. And truly, and I know deep down in that spirit, she loves the Lord.
Amen.
Amen. That's the most important thing. She loves the Lord. And you can see it within her spirit. And I truly thank God for you, Mother Bush. And I pray that God will bless you with many, 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 many more birthdays. Happy birthday.
God, and before that, we're just going to have one sermonic selection before the word comes forth. Come up, Sister Bush. Sister Tori Bush, come on up. You know who Sister Bush is. Amen. Amen. We're going to do this song. She didn't know we were going to do this song, but she didn't know we were going to do this song, but I felt this song was fitting. The words of the song are very simple, all the way. Truly, I know my mother believes it within her heart that she is going all the way with the Lord. No matter what the devil may throw at her, she is going all the way. Amen. So I ask that you pray with us as we sing this song.
Amen.
I've been using my voice all week, so I don't have my Luther tone on this morning. newly found friends who actually helped to get her here on today. I don't know if she has something she want to say, but I think I didn't want to omit you, but coming up here, Sister Brenda, let's say something. Amen. She helped get my mother here. We told a little, they call them a white lie, right? Amen. Lie's a lie. Amen. But amen. They get out here today. But here.
Praise the Lord, everybody.
Praise the Lord.
Yeah, oh, she was a hard one. She was a hard one. I told her, I said, listen, last week we had gone to a workshop. And I told her, I said, listen, this week I paid for you tickets to go somewhere with me. You can't turn me down. So she, on Thursday, we had gone to the AARP because I'm on their board. So we had such a good time. So I told her, I said, listen, remember, you have to dress because these people look up at the people that we go into. So you can't be, you can't dress down now. You gotta try to like one of these Sunday type suits. So then she told me, she said, well, exactly where are we going? I said, well, I'm the one that's doing the driving. I really honestly don't think you need to know where we're going. So I said, I told her, I said, listen, do me a favor, meet me at the church, and it may be good for you to just go ahead on it, because I'm gonna drive and you can always pick your car back up, because I have something to do afterwards. So when she came, I said, listen, I said, I got to do spam, we got to do spam rolls. So she said, okay, so then she said, you go in first. I said, no, you go in first. And that's how I got her. But she's such a beautiful
girl.
Yes.
Y'all players about this stuff in the church. Ain't gonna last.
All right.
Not gonna last.
Thank you, Lord.
Honey, the books are still burning.
Hey. Yes, sir.
The only thing that's going to stand is the Word of God. It's gonna stand forever. All this other stuff is gonna be consumed. It's gonna be burned up. It's gonna be lost. Right now.
Yes, sir. Come on.
Do it now.
Yes,
sir.
Yes, sir. I don't want nobody to know. Mm-hmm. One day everybody gonna know.
Yes, sir.
The Bible say the books are gonna be open.
Yes, sir.
And then another book gonna be open.
Yes.
And that's going to be the book.
That's the book.
That's the book, sir.
Yes, sir.
And guess what? Mm-hmm. Let me give a little slang here. Yeah. If your name ain't in it, you ain't going.
Yes, sir. All right.
Preaching.
Name is not in there.
Preaching. Talking good.
Man. You're not going.
Thank you.
To God be the glory.
To God be the glory. Yes.
The honor.
Yes.
And the majesty, brethren.
Oh. Yes.
And we glorify him.
Hallelujah.
And thank him for his grace and mercy.
Thank you, Lord. Yes.
If it were not for the grace and mercy of God,
that's right,
I'd be dead.
Amen.
Thank
you, Lord. Amen.
I was a mess.
Yes.
I was a wretch undone.
Yes.
Bought up in the church.
Preach
from a baby.
Preach it.
But didn't know God.
All right.
Didn't know
him.
Yes. Thank you, Lord.
I had been in and among the saints of God all my life.
All right.
I watched them shout.
Yeah.
I watched them dance before the Lord. Magnify and praise God's name all my life, but I did not know him.
Yeah, right.
Jesus.
Yes, sir.
I saw the hand and the work of God.
Come on.
Many times. But I didn't know him.
My Lord.
But I tell you, the day
thank you, God.
Came as I traveled on my Damascus road.
Go ahead, brother.
No God in my life.
Amen.
No purpose in my life.
Preach it.
Didn't care about anything or anybody.
In the name of Jesus.
Yes. Yes, sir.
The pedal was to the metal.
Yeah.
And I was going my own way.
Yes, Lord.
And I looked up one day and ran head on into Jesus Christ on my Damascus. The lights went out. When I opened my eyes, I had no pain. Didn't know whether I was dead or alive. Of Jesus said, boy, I've been good to you. Choose you this day.
Amen.
I made up my mind.
All right.
In a drunken stupor, my hands in the air, and I says, I'll serve you.
Yes. Thank you, God.
Yes.
When I came to myself and realized where I was at the back of the church and not in the front anymore. With my hand raised, surrendering my life to God.
Thank you, God.
And when I surrendered it to go all the way.
Yes, sir.
Now I'm not going to fool you. It's not been easy. But so far, I've made it to this point in my life.
Yes, Lord.
And I've made up my mind
that
I'm going
going all the way.
All right.
There has been trouble that's been poured out like water from a bucket. But my mind is made up.
Yes, sir. Yes.
That I'm going all,
yes.
The way.
Yes.
Somebody said a few minutes ago that you reminded them, Pastor Bush, of when you were growing up and all the children that you were taking in were like a commercial about a Volkswagen. They introduced me as Pastor Phillips, but let me introduce you to the Volkswagen man.
Come on.
I was the epitome of the Volkswagen man.
Yes.
My wife and I had a Volkswagen. That's how we got to church. My wife, my children, my neighbor children, and anybody else who would hitch a ride. We get to church, they couldn't believe how in the world all of us. And just one after another, they just come. We try to figure it out today. We talk about it today. Trying to count the number of people we had in that Volkswagen. And we can't figure out how in the world we got everybody in that Volkswagen. And we laughed and we talked and we enjoyed it. We went to church, went back to church. Everybody filed into the Volkswagen and everybody filed out. God is a wonder.
Yes.
God will fill your Volkswagen more than you can put. I don't know how he does it. But who knows the mind?
That's right.
Of God.
Yeah.
I heard one of the prayers made earlier as I sit in the back, and the prayer said this, or words to this effect. He said, Lord, we don't know why some of us live short.
Yeah.
And the rest of us, you live, let us live a little longer.
That's right.
We don't know the mind of God.
Yes.
But it pays you,
yeah,
to use whatever God gives you.
Yes. Yes.
Whether short or long.
That's right.
Live it to the fullest.
Yes. Yes.
You don't get a second chance. Before I say anything else, I'd like to say to you young people,
yes,
down to the baby, thank y'all for coming out here.
Amen. Yes. Yes. Amen.
I didn't see one of these little children get up and sing a solo, but they sit right here. They are here.
Amen.
And I think that's wonderful.
Amen.
To the young men, the youth, and to you all. And decided on a Saturday morning.
Yeah,
right. Well,
yeah.
I'm going to hell.
Yeah, praise God.
A lot of adults say we have so much to do on a Saturday morning.
Yeah.
But you know what? These kids got a lot to do too. They listen to television. But they're here.
Yeah. Yeah.
And I tell you, that means something.
Amen.
That means something.
Yes.
And you know why it bothers me when I don't see kids and a lot of kids in church? Mm-hmm. It takes me back to my childhood, and like I said, from a baby, my dad made sure we were in church.
That's right.
The boys went with daddy to the holiness church.
Yeah.
That's why sometimes I can't.
That's all right. All right.
All right. I only had one sister. She went with my mother to the Baptist church. They didn't quite have it going on at the time. And as I grew up, I could not understand what was wrong with those Baptist folks. The only thing I figured out, that Baptist people were not saved. Except for my mama.
Yes.
My mama had me say that's where she went. That was my mama. Everybody else ain't had nothing. And so I thought.
Yes.
But when you grow in the Lord, you find out that God's got folk that's here that you don't know about. Just because they don't do it like you do it, don't be the whole thing. It's the Spirit of God in your life that makes you different. And if you have the Spirit of God, you belong to Him. Expecting them kids gonna do something with me. It don't, let me tell you. You know, she said that don't have to be a birthday.
Yeah.
All right.
Them kids coming up with something. They thinking about something. They gonna do something. Yeah. And when you come over, I don't care if it's nothing but a remote control. I don't care if it's but a flower. I don't care if it's but a piece of candy. Mm-hmm. It means something. Yeah. Yeah. Right. Yeah. In life. Now I'm almost finished preaching. I'm gonna give you a scripture so you won't talk about it. See, there are some things in life, If you ain't got it in him.
All right, there you go. Yes.
That's right.
You can read all the scriptures.
Amen.
That you
yes.
Want.
Yes, sir.
But if you don't have a relationship with this and you ought to be able to grow in life,
yes, sir.
That you ought to be able to tell some kind of story without
that's
your
right.
Balance.
That's right. That's right.
There's something that you ought to have here in your heart.
Hallelujah. It's amazing what you can find in the Word of God. If you want to be successful in life, here's the place to find the formula for success.
That's it.
See, everything that you need to know and that God wants you to know is right here. Hello. But there are people, I don't care how much you preach to them, how much you teach to them. I walked in a restaurant, we went out to dinner, and somebody, the waitress, heard somebody say, Reverend Phillips. And the waitress came over to me, she said, do you have a word for me? Yeah, get saved. Get right
yes.
With God.
Yes.
You want a word? Get right.
Amen.
With God.
Yes.
Everybody looking for a word.
Come on.
Here it is.
It's right there.
Because that's the only way you're going to know if the word you get
yes.
Is real.
All right.
And right.
All right. Tell
if it's not backed up by here, it's a lie. It's from the devil, and you can tell the Reverend Philip told you. That's what the Bible says.
That's
if it contradicts this, it's a lie.
Yes. Yes. Yes.
If it doesn't match up with this, it's a lie.
That's right.
And it can't be half a loaf.
That's right.
It's got to be the whole loaf.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
When you go to the store to buy a loaf of bread, they bring you a half a loaf, what you do? You look at them like you're crazy, right?
Yeah, that's right.
Don't give me no half a story.
That's right.
And all the word they want to know is God going to give you this money.
Come on. Come on.
Food.
Come on. Come on.
That's it.
If I were rich, if you were rich, most of the people,
tell it.
If they would wake up in the morning and they were rich,
tell it.
With $1 million,
tell it. Come on.
Less than a year. They
that's right.
They've never been used to having any money, and let me tell you something. Everything they see, they buy, 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 buy. And don't say you won't because you be. Because you ain't never had no money. Once you got money, you think it never runs out.
All right. Yes, sir.
You want $1 million? Get a job. In fact, get your second job.
All right.
And then get you a part-time job. And save more
yes.
Than you spend.
Yes. Yeah. All right.
Stop trying to prove that you're somebody.
Come on.
Get $1 million, first thing you're going to do is go buy the biggest car they can buy.
Amen. Yes, sir.
Can't drive it. And can't get it in shoes.
Yeah.
What about the biggest car? Don't have a driver's license.
Yeah.
Food. That's just food. Buy stuff that they don't need just because they can buy.
Yeah. Yeah.
That's a food.
Yeah.
I'm going to get all of this stuff. And what are you going to do for it? What are you going to do? You'll be just like the rich man who was rich.
Right.
And had everything that he wanted. He was a farmer. Oh man, he had crops, he had bumper crops. Some of y'all kids don't know. Come on, bumper crops. But some of y'all know what bumper crops are.
Yes, sir.
That's when the more than what you expected
All right.
Comes up. Instead of having a bushel of tomatoes, you end up with 20 bushels.
That's right.
Instead of having 19 bushels of apples, you got 200.
Yeah.
Grain and corn and everything. This guy said, oh man, I got so much. And he got a Lazarus sitting outside his gate. And we pass him by and stick it all in the barn. Get the barn filled up and say, oh man, I got so much, what am I going to do with it? I need some bigger barn. I'm going to build me some bigger barn. Uh-huh. That's what food is.
Yeah.
And after you built those bigger barns,
yeah,
the Lord said, okay, you fool.
Yeah.
Yeah.
This night.
Yes.
Uh-huh. Come on.
Yes.
This night.
Yeah.
You could have fed the whole city, but this night.
Yeah.
You could have fed the poor, but this night.
Yeah.
You could have done a lot of good in your life, but this night, your soul shall be required of you.
Yes.
Now what?
That's the word.
Now, all of that stuff you got, who's going to use it?
Come on.
Who's going to need it? Who's going to spend it? Who's going to wear it?
You're right.
That's it.
You best think about some stuff.
Yes.
Psalm the 90th chapter and the 10th verse.
Oh, yes.
The days of our years are 80 years and 10. And if by reason of strength they be 80 years, yet is their strength labor and sorrow, for it is soon cut off and we fly away.
Oh, yeah.
Verse 12. So teach us the number of days that we may apply our hearts to understanding. Look at somebody and say, we don't have a whole lot of time.
We don't have a whole lot of time.
You got 70 years. And if by strength you get an extra 10, that would make you 80. That's your allotment. Anything beyond that is a God-given bonus.
Yes.
Some of us are never going to make it to 70. As the prayer says, some are cut short. They never even start living life before it ends. 80 years is not a very long time. But God gives us what he gives us to do everything that he's assigned our life to do. And living today is all about us. It's all about me. The church has changed. It's every man for themselves.
Yes, sir.
Nobody wants to help anybody. Everybody is trying their best to be better than everybody else in a carnal and a worldly way.
Yeah. All right.
They've taken the world and they bought it into the church and tried to mimic it and tried to scoot it in under things to make it look like that it's of God. But I want to tell you something, that the devil can transform himself into an angel of light. The devil can speak in tongues too, but it's not real. It doesn't mean anything. It doesn't edify anybody. It does nothing but confuse everybody. Having everybody want to have something of what you got that's not even real.
Amen.
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 Come on now. Come on.
They go outside and go down to the, used to be 5 and 10. They ain't got no more 5 and 10. They had to go down to Jake's. Or what's that other little dollar store?
Dollar
General and all of that. And they buy them a whole bunch of gold. Put it on their hand, put it on the wrist, put it on the fingers, come in to make you think, look man, I'm rich, I got all this gold. Follow them home. Look at that skin when they take it off. That will let you know where the tree is. Stuff like that wears off. It does not last. The real thing that you get from God lasts. You see this?
It lasts.
The last time I was here, she had been tottering on them things that she wasn't going to make it. But look at God.
Amen.
God can do exceedingly above.
Yeah.
said, "Oh, oh God, I got cancer. Stop worrying about it." That's the worst thing you can do, is worry. Because there's nothing you can do about it.
All right.
If you get cancer, ain't nothing you can do about it. You can go to the doctor and whatever. But everything is still in God's hands.
Yeah.
I've seen folk without cancer die. Just like that. And folk with cancer died to be 80 years old, 90 years old, 100 years old. They still got cancer. They're walking around. And you know what? They die of old age. God is able to keep you. He's able to keep that which you have committed to him. When you commit your life, you become God's responsibility, and God takes good care of his children. You don't have to go to court on God for no child support. God takes care of his own.
Yes, he does.
I'm done. I'm going to finish with this. I'm going to close with this. In the 5th chapter of the book of Matthew, there is a genealogy from Adam to Noah.
That's right.
And the average age that men live between Adam and Noah was 900 years.
That's right.
Did y'all hear what I read?
Mm-hmm.
You get 80?
Yeah.
Yeah.
How many of you in here hope to live to 200? I'm sorry. But I'm not going to walk that road with you. I don't want to live to no 200. God knows I don't. I really don't. If I get 80, I got 70. What? I got 71, I think. So I'm blessed.
Amen. Amen.
And I'm counting every day as a bonus for me.
Yes. Yes, sir. Amen.
I can still get up in the morning.
All right.
I can still tie my shoes.
Yes, amen.
I can still remember something.
Amen.
I can still feed myself. I can dress myself. I can shower.
Amen.
I can walk. I can talk.
That's right. That is good.
Can you imagine what it's going to be like tying your shoes when you get 900? Hello, somebody. And that is if you can remember how to tie.
That's right.
Amen.
I mean, look at this.
Yeah.
You bend down to tie your shoe, and you can't remember how to get back up. You walk 900 years? Still want to walk that 900 years? And the funny part is when you walk out of your house, outside, if you can remember where the door is. And when you get outside, or you come to church, nobody knows you, and you don't know nobody. You're 900 years old.
Yes.
That's going to be a mess. But people are trying it.
Yeah.
Every day you have scientists trying to develop stuff to make you make you younger.
Yes.
And some of us don't even realize it. We possess it. We who are saved already possess it.
Hallelujah.
We who are saved possess eternal life.
Yes, yes, yes.
Numbers quit.
All right. Yeah.
Clocks are gone.
All right. Yeah. Yes, sir.
Time ends.
Yes,
sir. I mean, eternity
yeah.
is longer than you can even think or hope.
Right.
It just goes on and on and on.
Oh, yeah.
We possess that
we possess
as Christians.
That's right.
And so therefore that should be our focus is to go all the way. So we can lay hold on eternal life. And holding on eternal life means a life without pain, without doubt, without anything ever going wrong in life.
Praise him. Praise him.
We don't have a long time.
Amen.
Use it to the glory of God.
Yeah, yeah.
Happy birthday, Pastor.
Amen.
I do want to acknowledge one of her duties.
found friends who actually helped to get her here today. I don't know if she has something she want to say, but I didn't want to omit you, but coming up here, Sister Brenda, let's say something. Amen. She helped get my brother here. We told a little, they call him a white lie, right? Amen. Lie's a lie. Amen. But amen. But hey.
Praise the Lord, everybody.
Praise the Lord.
Yeah, she was a hard one. She was a hard one. I told her, I said, listen, last week we had gone to a workshop. And I told her, I said, listen, this week I paid for you tickets to go somewhere with me. You can't turn me down. So she, on Thursday, we had gone to the AARP because I'm on their board. So we had such a good time. So I told her, I said, listen, remember, you have to dress because these people look up at the people that we go into. So you can't be, you can't dress down. Now you gotta try to like one of these Sunday type suits. So then she told me, she said, well, exactly where are we going? I said, well, I'm the one that's doing the driving. I really honestly don't think you need to know where we're going. So I said, I told her, I said, listen, do me a favor, meet me at the church, and it may be good for you to just go ahead on it, because I'm going to drive, and you can always pick your car back up, because I have something to do afterwards. So when she came, I said, listen, I said, I got to do spam, you got to do spam. So she said, okay, she said, you go in first. I said, no, you go in first. And that's how I got her. But she's such a beautiful girl.
Without any further ado, we ask everybody to rest on your feet, and we're going to call on the honoree of the hour. We're going to give her a remark. She looks so beautiful on her arm.
Yeah. Amen. It just really was a surprise today. Sister Brenda